All right, so I know you guys remember the Rock Block deal on Shark Tank where the guy, he sold the entire company for $500,000. Was that a smart thing? I'm going to show you how he could have sold the company for like a whole lot more, millions more, if he even wanted to sell the company. He didn't have to, but they always get us like that. Anyway, how much is Rock Block worth now? Watch this. The current net worth of $5 million in sales of $959,000 speaks volumes about the story of Rock Block. Rock Block has been in high demand and is out of stock a freaking moment. Now, keep watching, guys, because I'm going to show you how he could have kept all of his equity, all of his royalties, and he only needed a simple marketing campaign. He didn't even have to go on there and sell to Robert. Robert played him and then don't even own it anymore. Look at this, man. So Kevin offering him $300K, 50%. They're always trying to play us. And then $500,000 for 100% of Rock Block. And then they always want to give you a job. You're trying to be an entrepreneur, but he gives them a 2-year job contract. This is horrible. Now watch this. All he had to do was simply rank on YouTube for a Bluetooth vinyl recorder, Bluetooth vinyl record player. Okay, as you can see, when you search Bluetooth vinyl record player, it's competitors, but you don't see anybody but Amazon. If you want to win, you have to copy success. If Amazon is on the first page of Google for this, that means that your company should be on the first page of Google for this. He made it all the way to Shark Tank on TV, but he didn't even go after a real marketing campaign. People want other people to do it for them, which is why they get played, okay? So guess what? If he took a couple $100s or maybe even $1,000 or $2,000 and put it into a marketing campaign, he could have been right here getting orders every day. As you can see right here, look, where was it? Where it says, okay, Rock Block was selling 100 to 200 units daily. Come on, man. 100 to 200 units daily, man. He could have been ahead of all that, selling it straight from his website direct to consumer. We do not need all of that, okay? So watch this. Now next, the next step is not just positioning for that keyword. You want to do what's called brand jacking, which is making your brand show up when people search for your competitors so you can steal or jack their customers from them straight front. So when a person would search for Sony's Bluetooth record player, Rock Block's would have been the one that showed up if he came to someone like me instead of Sony. As you can see, Sony is brand jacking. Look at it. Sony and Amazon are brand jacking. This is what you put your money towards, okay? Ranking and showing up for your competitors' names so that their customers will come to you instead. Like, boom, look at this. UDreamer record player Bluetooth instructions, okay? So people are looking for this, okay? And all Rock Block had to do before he even went on there was to show up for his competitors' names, position itself a Bluetooth vinyl record player, boom, audio. This is the last one that we have. This is what he could have did. And he would have been able to retain all of his ownership rights, not have to go from entrepreneur to working a job at the company that he freaking created. That is freaking lunacy to me. I don't understand how people be letting people cut them back down to size after they make it away from the 9 to damn 5, okay? So he